and gentlemen, welcome to another episode of Coin News Extra Interview Session. Joining us today on Coin News Extra Interview is a paytech expert and fintech expert, Massimo Baron. Massimo Baron, you are welcome to Coin News Extra.
It's a pleasure, Lee. Thank you for inviting me on the show.
Okay, you are welcome. So today we'll be talking about integration of blockchain into the payment system. So as a fintech expert, Massimo will be helping us to talk about this topic briefly. But before we proceed, Massimo, can you just give us a brief about yourself?
Yes, I'm an entrepreneur, last 20 years. I'm born in Montreal, Canada. I've been in the payment industry for a little over 25 years. I've had the success of starting three tech companies, all which have from private have become public companies. And I enjoy startups. And my favorite pastime is bringing technologies to market and helping commercialize them and develop them into products.
So moving straight to the topic, as a fintech and payment expert, paytech expert and fintech expert, so some people don't really know much about what payment remittance and whatever paytech and remittance is all about. Can you just briefly give us what it is?
Sure. You know, to define payments, you have to understand a little bit of all the structures. You know, you have payment rails using bank wiring methods or credit cards, debit networks. And then you have all the different methods of payment that you have to consider, you know, contactless, contact, you know, EMV chip and PIN. You know, we have e-commerce, mobility. So there's so many different variations, and each model is specific to its needs with the industry that you have to serve. And if it's retail oriented, or if you're servicing you know, like an airline industry, which requires very specific protocols and compliance in order to service customers. My business is developed on the strategy where we have developed special business processes that we can easily implement right away. We allow our customers to take that strategy and get to market commercial deployment at a very fast pace, with a lot of the compliance and security built into the payment requirements by issuing and acquiring banks around the world.
Okay, that's very good. Let us know some of the challenges that the fintech and the paytech is facing currently.
Okay. Well, prior to the COVID problem, a big part of the fintech challenges around the world, I think, is dealing with legacy systems and the adoptability by financial institutions to the new technologies in every market. You know, the client wants one product, but the banks, you know, they have a way of working, you know, from introducing a product to underwriting it, you know, measuring risk and fraud and how they want it to be compliant and how they roll it out into a market. You know, today's customer sees something new and, you know, they want it immediately, where, you know, there's a lot of red tape in order for that to happen. And a lot of the challenges are, you know, the banks and a lot of telecom companies in processing, just to give an example, have, you know, legacy systems. So in order to front end a product or a new technology, there's a lot of work behind it in order for it to go through the pipeline. And one of the big challenges there is that the banks in the past decade, or in the past 30, 40 years, most of them don't own their own technology. They've had a third party vendor, you know, some of the large corporations in the world to service them. So the flexibility for them to navigate and deploy is a challenge. And that problem comes into the fintech market because we have so many great technologies, but the banks don't have the resources to let them all go through. And the ones they do select have to go through a vigorous compliance method in order for them to be compliant. And sometimes we lose the best technologies because the fintech companies who are developing them are junior or startups and don't qualify the vendor programs in order to be admissible. So there's a lot of challenges in order for a company to get through the red tape in order for it to be a viable solution.
Okay, that's interesting. So having known some of the problems and challenges confronting the paytech and fintech, so how do you think blockchain can play a role in this sector? And how do you think blockchain can help in solving some of these challenges?
You know, blockchain is a whole new environment for banks. The last few years, tokenization for payment already had started to evolve. With blockchain coming into the market, everyone thinks blockchain is a solution. It's not, you know, it's a tool. And I think it's how you use it in a process on how to deliver to the customer or the business. You know, blockchain doesn't guarantee security. It guarantees a protocol being used to protect the information. But, you know, where you put your software or how you host it and how you secure it is fundamental. So, you know, when you look at the industry as a whole, it's, you know, what does your solution look like? Turnkey, not just, well, you know, the solution you're trying to provide. Because, you know, when you're dealing with, a major financial institution or enterprise, they need to understand your architecture. They need to understand your support, your compliancy, you know, your auditing tools, and basically how you're going to effectively manage the solution once it's in the market. So there's a lot of variables to consider when we discuss blockchain and what it will be used for.
Okay, interesting. The blockchain is not the actual solution to all this. Many people think otherwise. So coming to a conclusion, how is this pandemic, the coronavirus situation, how is it affecting the paytech and fintech industry?
It had two different effects. From a personal experience right now, it did slow down some of the projects that were underway, but it accelerated many issues. You know, most banks, you know, it would take them 4 or 6 months to a year to bring a project or to be able to change or make any decisions. With all that's going on now, the governments are realizing that, you know, face-to-face compliance is a big challenge. So, you know, we ourselves developed a product called Granular Chain, which is a EKYC product that creates a digital ID for compliancy. So we've seen this product push through red tape pretty quickly because the banks and financial institutions are challenged by not being able to have physical meetings. And the whole body of government, everywhere in the world, and regulators, you know, face-to-face with your client is a very significant part of due diligence. We've seen that almost deteriorate, and now everyone's adopting a quick measure or technology in order to facilitate it. Now, not every government has approved this method, but because of this whole COVID factor, you know, a lot of red tape has been removed, and the risk and fraud level has increased dramatically for underwriters to be able to evaluate what the future risk of not meeting their client is going to bring them.
Okay, that's very interesting. Thank you very much, Massimo Baron, for joining us today on Coin This Extra Interview.
Thank you so much. It was a pleasure, Lee.